Kia ora guys, how's it going? Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the build on the $100 disco version 2.5. We're continuing on where we left in the last video, which if you missed, it is up there for you. In the last video, basically, we were working on the rear end of the truck, throwing some tubes in there and getting ready for mounting hydro bump stops. So, no surprises this video, that's exactly what we're tackling, fitting hydro bump stops to the rear end so that this truck basically will just handle the big bumps a whole lot better.
Unfortunately, this morning Tim noticed that he had a piece of metal or something in his eye from yesterday that did not want to come out. So he is currently at the A&E getting that removed. So yeah, just me working on Hyundai this morning, unfortunately. So what I've been working on so far before I picked up the camera is this bar here. Just getting this all notched and getting this over here notched, as you can see, so that our pipe will slot in something like that in order to attach the bump stop here over where my thumb is.
Alright guys, well I'm back, only briefly just to do some welding. I've just been inside doing some editing. Matt's done an awesome job just cranking it out. Anyway, I'm just going to grab some acetone, clean up these mounting cans for the hydro bumps.
Thanks.
That he has nabbed. So I'll clean those up and then I'll weld them in. Guys, so as you can see, we've got the hydro cans tacked in place. It looks awesome. It's so cool to see, you know, the first suspension parts going in. Huge thank you to Matt for cranking out on the grinder all day, notching and getting that all looking so absolutely schmick. It's wonderful. Sucks that I've not been building today, but can't do much about it. Anyway, it's looking real good. So yeah, we'll continue on. I'm not sure what the next step is. Probably another tube to tie into the hydro mounts.
Alright, so since I last picked up the camera, I have gone and made the other set of brace bars for the hydro bumps.
Wheel back on just because of the way we redesigned it, we now have to remeasure for the new bump stop pads. So we've got it all flexed up at about an inch and a bit clearance around the tires, and you can see we've probably got we've got a little bit of room that we need to
2 inches.
Yeah, a couple of inches that we need to extend it. So that is the next and probably final job for this evening, is make those up. And then that's the bump stops pretty much done. We'll probably throw a few more tubes around the can at a later date, but for the time being, that'll do the trick. Right, so as you can see, we've got the template in. Looks good. Obviously, it's at an angle, but that's because we've got the axle all flexed up. So that pad should sit level, parallel with the axle, once the axle's flat. However, unfortunately, we have not got the material we need to make it. So that's gonna be us for the night. We're gonna wrap up here and we'll continue on once we've got some material.
What is this?
What?
What is this I've just
picked up? How did I not find that?
I think we're building some bump stop pads.
Oh, I was kind of looking forward to an early night, not gonna lie.
Not anymore, boys. We're on.
We'll be right back. one side welded in, one of the bump stop pads. We've got the other one here. Basically what we've done is we've just painted the inside of them, just so that there's not going to be any rust forming inside. So we'll slap this one on, and then that's the bump stop pads done. We can jack it up and see how it all looks, all schmickin' all together. Right guys, well it's another weekend back working on Hyundai. We kind of ground to a stop last weekend, mostly just because I'm a perfectionist and just I wasn't quite happy with the bump stops. We had a few problems that they were mounted, well that the mounts on the axles, they're too high. So I'll just show you now, we're not getting anywhere near to full bump, so we're losing a lot of suspension travel. That's a good good at 1.5-2 inches, and that also then even more affects the axle when the axle's parallel, so rather than flexed up. So we definitely needed to get that sorted. So these mounts that we made need fixing anyway, but you can also see that the hydro is landing really forward and on the corner of it. There was many discussions had about what to do, like moving the pad forwards and having it hanging over the edge. However, ultimately, I'm trying to do this build right. As much as it pains Matt, because he spent ages notching tubes, but we're going to move the hydros back and then remake two of the tubes.
Nah, so. No. We aren't going to do that. You are going to do that.
We're going to move it back and then I'm going to remake the tubes. Anyway, so first things today is, we're going to mount it with this tube alone. Just cut those tacks, move it back, and then I can tackle remaking these tubes at a later date. But that'll reposition the hydro in the right spot so that we can then get these bump stop pads moved outboard a little bit and trimmed down, so that we lose some of that gap. Obviously you still want some gap, however that much we're just losing out on the potential travel, so we'll fix that up and I guess we'll crack into that first. So we've just moved the hydros back. As you can see, it's now landing square in the middle of the bump stop pad forwards and backwards. Obviously we've still got to move the pad outwards quite a bit, out that way. We'll just get this tacked in. A few beefy tacks and that should have it sorted.
So what Tim is currently doing is just marking out where he needs to notch the pipe to join it into here.
It's been a very productive day of getting back to the start of where we were. So. Anyway, next step will be start moving the bump stop pads around, I think. Oh no, we've got to do some trimming to make, so we can make up some plates to fill the gaps. Just down in there. Righto guys, well that is everything back together, bump stops relocated, tubes remade, and yeah, that's a whole day done and dusted. We had a bit of a late start, but 7 hours work, and we're back to where we were at the start. But I tell you what, I'm so much happier with that. We do obviously still need to move the bump stop pad outwards on the axle, so that it's landing in the middle there. But yeah, it's just so much happier knowing that it's done right. Really just want to, you know, build this truck right, especially seeing as, you know, it's going to see, I guarantee it's going to see a number of years of abuse. So nice knowing that we've, you know, done it properly. Anyway, it's not like you haven't seen it before, but there you go again. I'm going to pack up for the time being, and I don't know if this is the end of the video or not. Yes, Tim from the past, that is the end of the video. It's awesome to have the hydros in. Obviously those pads still need relocating outboards more on the axle. However, taking the time to you know, redo the tubes to get the hydros exactly where I want them, it was a difficult decision just because of the number of hours that I know Matt put into it. However, definitely worth doing. I'm very pleased with the outcome. I encourage you guys, you know, when you're doing these builds, like, build to the best of your ability. I was very tempted to sacrifice and you know, cut corners just for the sake of time. However, redoing it, I'm just going to be so much more pleased with the end product. So anyway, that's it for this week. Make sure to hit subscribe to stay tuned for, you know, the build on this and everything else we've got coming if you haven't already. Give us a like if you've enjoyed today's video. Leave a comment down below what you thought, tips, advice, anything you learnt. I'd love to hear from you. Anything you want to see, also let me know. And yeah, well that's it. I'll catch you all on the next one. Thank you all so much for watching. We'll see you then.
First one of the day and it burned my head.